What do you look for in a doctor? What makes a good doctor? I believe, one, he must be competent. He must have the skills, the experience, the know-hows. But secondly, I believe it's a matter of the heart. He needs to be someone who is genuinely concerned for his patients. He has integrity. He has love for the people. And so these two things are important. Skills and integrity. That's what it takes also to be a good teacher, by the way. You need to care for the students. You need to teach them for their benefit. And you need to be competent. You need to be skilled. I believe that's the same for a pastor. If we are to shepherd people to Jesus, then we need both the skills and the integrity of our hearts. You see, in Psalm 78 and verse 72, the Bible says, "So he," that is David, "fed them," that is Israel, "according to the integrity of his heart and guided them by the skillfulness of his hands." These two things are important, the integrity of his heart and the skillfulness of his hands. It's not either or, but it's both. To shepherd people, your heart must be right and your hands must be skilled. I believe that's the same for being a pastor. If you want to serve people, you want to shepherd people, you want to lead in small groups or discipleship groups or mentoring groups, then it requires both your heart and your hands. A heart that desires to be honest to God and to people, a heart that is sincere in helping others, and integrity. And then you need the hands. You need to have the skills to know how to help people in the Bible, in scripture, in prayer, in following Jesus, in evangelism. And so I think these are the two things I'd like to leave with you. Ask God today to give you a heart that loves Him and loves people. And ask God today to bring into your life people who can help you with the skills necessary. And as you do so, I believe you can serve God as a SF or care group, discipleship group leader much more effectively. And may God raise up many, many good leaders, many, many good shepherds, because the laborers are few. God bless.